The Florida Gators have staked their claim for the national championship of 1996.
Here's Tebow. Jump pass. Throw it to the end zone. And a touchdown. David Nelson scores.
Walk back down. You can stand me up at the gates.
Dropping back to throw. Pumps and fires the ball over the middle. It's there. It's there. Got a touchdown. Dory got a touchdown. Oh, man.
Won't be turned around.
Not a body within 10 yards. Lofting down the sideline for Johnson. And he is level.
All right, it's time for another edition of Gator Glory, brought to you by Safe Harbor Seafood. And we're going to go down south where they got some good seafood in the Miami area. And they have a former Gator great at safety. Major Wright joins us right now. And Major, first, thanks for joining us. I was thinking this before we got started. And I've been around University of Florida football since like the mid-80s. When I was a freshman, there was a big safety back there named Lewis Oliver. And he would deliver some heavy hitting in his career. But pound for pound, when it came to safety tandems in the history of the University of Florida, I would rank you and Ahmad Black at the top. I mean, you guys packed a wallop, and you weren't afraid to use it. Do you think that's what kind of defined you as a football player at Florida?
First and foremost, thank you for having me on. I appreciate the opportunity to get on here and, you know, discuss, you know, my good old days. And I'm not that old, so I'm not gonna let you put that in my head. I'm not that old.
I am, but that's another topic.
But me and Ahmad tandem, I feel like we was the best tandem that came through University of Florida, and I think that's hands down, because at any aspect of the game we could go get the ball, you know. I think nobody's done what we've done while we was at University of Florida, and I think that's kind of what we're lacking right now in the back end right now.
Take me back to being recruited by Urban Meyer. The program is coming off a national title. That's got to be, you know, very attractive right off the bat. But part of that national title, a big part, is another Gator great, Reggie Nelson. And so here you are. I mean, you're a high school All-American. You're a big-time recruit, and you are confident in what you can do. But I would imagine those are pretty big shoes to fill. So how did that go, you know, in conversations during recruiting, and what was your mentality as you showed up for camp as a freshman?
Oh, man, that whole recruiting process was amazing. It was a time in my life that I didn't know where I was going to go, and I didn't know, you know, what school I was going to go to. So it kind of made it very interesting, because I've never been through this process before, and my family has never been through this process before. So me figuring things out on the go was amazing. But them coming off a national championship, beating Ohio State, because I had Ohio State and Florida my number one and number two at that time. So them beating Ohio State kind of gave them a little leverage. But then, you know, that they had Reggie Nelson leaving, as you mentioned. They had Reggie Nelson leaving, and Reggie Nelson, those were some, when I mean some huge shoes to fill, oh, my God. But it opened up an opportunity for me, you know, to at least have a chance at starting, you know. And then with it being so close to Florida and from Fort Lauderdale and where I'm from, it made it so much easier for me to make that choice, because my family wouldn't have to travel so far and spend so much money to come see me play, you know. But when I got in there, my mentality was to go prove to these coaches that I'm better than what they have here. And I made sure I made that statement the first day we put on shoulder pads and helmet.
Nice.
We didn't even have them full pads, but I wanted to make sure I showed the coaches that I was better than what they had there.
Well, the story goes that you were very ambitious as a practice player, right, as a freshman. You open eyes by banging pads, don't you, when you're a safety?
Yeah. I mean, listen, for me, I knew what I brought to the game. I know my strong points of the game, and I know what people, like, you know, some of my college teammates, they didn't know what I really was capable of. They kept hearing about this. They kept saying, oh, yeah, you know, when you get to college, we're going to see much guys much bigger, you know, guys this and that. So my mentality had when it was already spunk. I was already on fire, you know, to go out here and prove to them that, hey, Major got it. You know, if it's any doubt, don't play with Major. So first day, man, they hand Chris Rainey off while we in the scrimmage. They hand Chris Rainey off the ball. I come downhill full speed and just like deplete him. And I mean, lay him out. I ended practice. I was the first freshman of Urban Meyer to end practice, to shut practice down.
Oh, those are the days, my man. What's it like playing for Urban? I mean, he's a very complex person. He can seem very intense at times. He can seem very pensive at others. He can seem quiet at times. He can seem outgoing at others. What made him a coach that could win two national titles in 3 years?
Man, honestly, man, he knows his stuff, man, and he's just not like, you know, a regular coach. He really knows how to get everything out of a player, you know, and he know how to make you buy into the program. And I think once you get a player to buy into your system or the program, whatever you got going on, best out of that player. And Coach Urban Meyer knows how to get the best out of his players. And you know, he does have his moments where he's just like, what are you doing? You know, like, what we got going on? Because I even had a moment with him where, why I left school early. You know, a lot of people don't know why I left school early. Think I just left because, you know, I wanted to leave my junior year. But, nah, that wasn't the case, you know. Kind of had my running too with Coach Urban Meyer, and, you know, it kind of forced me to leave early.
Huh? You want to expand on that, or are you going to leave it at that?
So no, I'm going to leave it at that, okay. Because I got a lot of that in my book. You know, I talk about okay. that in my book, and I go in depth with everything on why I left school early. You know, what happened with my run into, but I set that up just for you to ask me that.
Well, you know what? The book is Major Pain: Confessions of a Smash Mouth Safety, and you were that. You were a Major Pain for the opposition and certainly brought the Smash Mouth part. Listen, by the way, I don't mean to present to you guys out there in podcast land, Major Wright is just some thumper. I mean, my man had 8 career interceptions, 4 forced fumbles. You were a playmaker. That defined that defense at the time as well. So tell me what went into the decision to write the book and some of the other juice we're going to get in there in addition to the reason for leaving in 09.
Well, I've never been like a great writer or a great reader. And I was on the phone with one of my ex-girlfriends at the time, and we were just uplifting each other, you know. And in the middle of our conversation, she mentioned, Major, you should write a book. And I paused. I'm like, hold on. I'm thinking in my head, write a book. Man, I'm not good at neither reading or writing. So how am I going to go out here and go write a book? But at that time, I was reading The 15 Invaluable Laws of Growth by John Maxwell. And in his book, he mentions, if you want to do something, act on it now or it'll never happen. So I took that opportunity to really, you know, see if this is really true. So I was very intentional about writing this book, man. I went upstairs after we got off the phone. I grabbed my notepad and I grabbed a pen. And I just started outlining chapters that I wanted to talk about. The next day, I woke up. When it worked out, came back home, and I just started writing. And it just started flowing, and it started feeling good, just talking about the things that I've went through, the things that I've accomplished, the things that, you know, things I never look back to, like, say, damn, Major, you did do this. Like, wow, bro, you know, I was just living in that moment, writing at the time, and that's how, you know, the book came about. And it has been amazing being able to share my experience with people and to be able to help people get through the things that they're going through.
The book is Major Pain, Confessions of a Smash Mouth Safety, as we continue with the Gator Glory podcast, brought to you by Safe Harbor Seafood. And Major, I guess you can get the book at all your typical outlets. Where do people go if they want to find a copy?
So you can get it. You can get it on Amazon, or you can go to majorwright.com. If you want a personal signed book, you can go in there and get your book done. And not just, you know, that, you know, my book. I I have my publishing company. I started my own publishing company. It's called the Wright Publishing Company. You guys can go on there if you guys need any type of assistance, or if you want a website done, if you want anything done on the internet, my publishing company can make that happen for you. I got the Right Way Foundation, where we help single parent moms. We help clothe them, we help feed them, we help provide them insurance, we help provide them financial literacy. I'm out helping now, so I'm out doing my job and doing what I do best.
Good on you, my man. Good on you. All right. Listen, I've covered Major Wright 1,000 Florida football games. Maybe not 1,000. A whole bunch. I've been to just about every big game the school's ever played, okay? I've stood on the field back in the day. You know, the media, they let us stand on the field. It was even better. And you'd hear the pads pop when you stood on the field. But I was at that 2000. I was there in January 2009, and I was way on the other side of the stadium, and I was halfway up the stadium, and I'm pretty sure I heard the pads pop. It may have been the first play of the game. It was early in the game. When you lit up that poor Oklahoma receiver, he might be in La La Land right now. Do you, as that play unfolded? Oh, by the way, before I get you to talk about that play, today you'd be penalized 100 yards and you'd be suspended for 2 years for that play. That was a hard hitting. That was a hard hitting football play.
For that play. I would have been arrested. They would have put me in cuffs as soon as I would hear him. They would have put me in the cuffs.
Yeah, I'm not kidding.
But that play, it was the third play of the game. Oklahoma, they was going up tempo, so we was kind of tired a little bit. You know, I mean, we practiced it, but it's nothing like doing it in a game. You know what I'm saying? So they went up tempo. The first two plays and third play, they try to catch us on our heels. And they hit a double move on Joe Hayden to the right. And before the game, I had told my DBs, I'd say, listen, y'all, I got y'all back no matter what. Whatever it is, I'm going to make sure I do my job and I hold y'all down. So I made sure, like, before that play even happened, like, I had already had in my mind, listen, I got to make sure I'm here to be here for my, you know, my corners and my whoever else who needs me on the team. So They hit Joe Hayden with a double move, and Bradford pumped. He pumped the same way he threw, so he kind of made me lean to the hash that he was throwing to. So once he released the ball, I had already knew. I don't want nothing to do with this ball. I want to make sure I strike fear into this player that the rest of this team, if they ever come across the middle, they're going to say, man, you know what, man, Major right there, I'm not doing this no more.
Well, I was scared, so.
I'm not doing this no more.
It worked. Now, let me ask, you know, as a Gator grad, as a broadcaster who's covered these games that we're talking about, I'm wondering which leaves the bigger – does that national championship win, is that the crowning achievement? I know it's the biggest thing that you won at Florida as a team, but is that the game that was most memorable? It seems like those, you know, the 08 and 09 championship games with Alabama carried to me being in those buildings almost as much or more juice as that national title game did. So just kind of rank for me the top couple, and then we'll call it a wrap.
I honestly, listen, I'm going to tell you this. One of the most memorable games for me was my freshman year. We played LSU, mm-hmm. at LSU. And when I tell you, their stadium was so loud. And me being a freshman, I've never witnessed anything like this, you know. And playing in it, you know, not just sitting on the sideline. And, you know, I'm actually out there playing in it. So I'm sitting on the sideline one play, and me and Joe sitting right next to each other. I'm screaming Joe's name. Joe! Joe! He can't hear me. He's looking like, what's going on? He's looking to the right. He's looking at the game. And I'm like, wow, man, he's really tapping. I'm like, bro, you didn't hear me calling? He's like, bro, I can't hear you. You can't hear me. What are you talking about?
Man, yeah.
But that game, and then when Jacob, you know, Hester, kind of trucked me. It really made me switch my whole game up.
Mm-hmm.
After I got trucked, after that game, I told myself I'd never let that happen to myself ever again. I would never let somebody, you know, willpower me like that. And that game right there stood out to me. And that play, you know, really, 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 like, made me step my game up a lot more. But as you mentioned, like, of course, we got to mention the Alabama, you know, Alabama game. Every game they brought the A game, you know, in 2008 and 2009, they made sure they brought the A game. But I want to say, I just want to put that LSU at LSU game as probably one of my most memorable games.
Well, that's awesome. It's one reason we love getting this perspective on you guys. It's a major right, just an All-American superstar player, helping the Gators win a national title in 2008, actually in January 2009. And he's our guest today on Gator Glory, brought to you by Safe Harbor Seafood. Major, we appreciate it so much. Keep it up with all your endeavors. It's great to hear the positivity in your voice. You still keep up with the guys? I mean, man, I was looking at that defensive lineup. I count 15 or 16 of you jokers who played in the NFL. And when I say played, I mean, 2, 3, 4, 7 years is how long you played. Man, what so much talent.
Yeah, man, listen, man, we got a group chat. We got a Gator group chat going on, man. And we actually have some really good stuff that the Gator Nation can look forward to. When I tell you we got some big stuff coming up, well, you guys going to be proud and you guys going to say, God damn, you know what? This was it. You know, we got some good stuff in the works. So, we got a good group chat going on, so we do still keep in contact. And you know, on social media, you know, you see your guys got something going on or what they're doing. You know, you DM them and communicate like that. You know, but we definitely all created something that's gonna continue to beat up for the rest of our lives. So I think from here on out, man, that brotherhood we created, man, that don't go nowhere.
Major Wright, appreciate it. Thank you, my man. Continued success.
Thank you, man. Appreciate you having me, bro.